In this video, we're talking about the nomenclature of binary molecular compounds. Well, what is a binary molecular compound? Well, binary, just like in binary ionic compounds, in binary molecular compounds means that there are two and only two elements. Molecular, though, means that both of these elements are nonmetals as compared to a binary ionic compound where one of the elements is a metal, the other is a nonmetal. To name a binary molecular compound, all you do is say the name of the first element, and then say the name of the second element, changing its ending to IDE. Then the ending of the second element becomes IDE. Also, in order to say how many of each element there are, we're going to use these prefixes. I'll show you these in just a second. But remember, there's no mono for the first element. I'll show you what I mean in a second. So these are the prefixes. Memorize these, right? Memorize them, got it? Mono means one, di means two, tri three, tetra four, penta five, hexa six, hepta seven, octa eight, nona nine, deca 10, undeca 11, dodeca 12. And so if there's only one atom of the first element in the molecule, then we don't put a mono in front of the first element's name. But otherwise, you know, we use mono for the second element, and we use all the other prefixes for the first. So to name this compound right here, both of these elements are nonmetals, nitrogen and oxygen. There's one of each. We don't put a mono in front of the nitrogen, but we do the oxygen. So we just say nitrogen monoxide. This compound, though, this is N2O. There are two nitrogens, so we say dinitrogen, and we say monoxide. Now, monoxide is acceptable, but usually when there's two vowels together, we drop one of them. This compound here, phosphorus and oxygen are both metals, nonmetals, excuse me. There are four phosphorus, 10 oxygens, so we say tetraphosphorus, decoxide. We dropped the A because we had two vowels next to each other. Here, one sulfur, six fluorines. Sulfur and fluorine are both nonmetals. We do not use a mono for the sulfur, so we just say sulfur, hexafluoride. Going the other way, from the name to the formula, if we see the words carbon dioxide, so carbon is C, oxide means oxygen, di means there's two oxygens. Because there's no prefix in front of the carbon, we know that there's only one. Dinitrogen tetroxide, di means two nitrogens, tetra means four, so four, and oxide means oxygens. Phosphorus pentachloride, phosphorus is P, no prefix, so that means there's just one. Penta is five, chloride is chlorine, so five chlorines. By the way, when you're writing the formula for a binary molecular compound, the most metallic element is always written first, and the less metallic is written second. Remember, in the periodic table, the trend is that elements become less metallic as you go up and to the right, and so the element that's the furthest down and to the left will be the first one, and the one that's the most up and to the right in the periodic table will be the second one.